Well, praise the Lord. Amen. Good to see everybody. It's a beautiful day that the Lord hath made. I will rejoice and be glad. Amen. We're going to have a good time in the Lord this morning. I've already been having a good time in Sunday school. And you know, I just sense his presence this morning. He's going to move. Amen. And it's up to us and us folks on the internet. And by the way, we invite the folks on the internet. We thank you for being with us this morning. Because I just feel like God's going to move and just receive. And there comes the Pennsylvania boy. I see he's back from Pennsylvania. Good to see him back. Praise God. And we're going to go to the Lord in prayer in just a minute. Before we do, we got a few announcements we want to make. And got some folks out sick. Want to think about that. And praise God. Let me tell you what you got good going for you this morning. You're not one of the folks out sick. Amen. Let me tell you something else you got good going for you. God loves you. You're blessed. Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Now, let's look at a couple things this morning before we get started here. And this morning, Buddy Whitworth's going to have a blood drive, I believe, soon at the lower clock on 123 and Washington Avenue this evening from 1 to 6. So those who can, go give blood to help Buddy. Is he doing recovering, still good, looking good? Amen. Praise God. He's coming along, all right, Sue? He was in a bad way, and God's just brought him back. Praise God. We're thankful for that. And Caleb Curtis, I seen that rascal yesterday on a nice-looking lawnmower, by the way. He's amazing, me. Man, he's just doing good. BR and us was working over there at Jeanette's the other day, and, man, he's working like a little. Him and Nathan was really doing it. And me and BR was doing some things we had to do. We done got tired, Nathan. That's what's going on. But praise the Lord, you know, I'm real excited to see that young man the way he's going. And, you know, and Kendra's son, Casey, he needs prayer. He's been going to the emergency room about some stuff and about his head and stuff. We're going to pray for him in just a minute. Donnie Deal's got some things going on, too. Need to pray for him. You know, we got a prison service tonight, and Donnie and Betty always goes and sing and helps us minister to those folks. But Donnie's got something going on. We need to pray that God's going to just heal him in a speedingly way. And reminding the folks, too, we got the prison service tonight. Gene and Joanne and Charles and some of us will be going. And I think, Charles, you get the key to that van. Need to ask, Nathan, can you get the key to the van and give to Charles, if you don't mind, please, sir? And Steve's got a back problem, Peggy, I think, pretty bad, too. He's in the bed, so that's a terrible thing. I tell you right now, a lot of us have been there, too, and so we're going to pray about Steve. My mother's sick, got some stuff going on, a lot of stuff. Cheryl is sick, Griffin, and we're going to pray for her. Also, we got Vacation Bible School coming up next weekend, so y'all be in much prayer about that. And but God's on the move, praise God. We're going to have a good time this morning, and we're going to praise the Lord and just fellowship with him this morning. And we're going to pray for some of these folks right here this morning, too, because you know, prayer, that moves mountains in our lives. Amen. Things that's going on in our lives. God is a God who hears our prayers. He's a true living God. Amen. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. And I'm excited. We're going to have a good time this morning. Praise God. Yes, Sharon. Let's hear a praise report. Hold on just a minute. Wait a minute. We want the other folks to hear this praise report. I tell you right now, I like them, don't you? Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah.
I asked the church to pray for my child that goes to my mom's church. And the lady, it was unborn, remember, and they said it had no spine and that she didn't have enough fluid that she would have the child. And they wanted her to abort it. And said if she didn't, it would be born still dead, you know. And so she said she wasn't going to do that, and she kept praying and all. Well, last week she had a healthy baby. The spine was just perfect. And we give, you know, God all the glory, and that was just wonderful. They had such great faith all the way through, and so it was awesome.
Praise God. Give God the glory. Now, that's answered prayer right there. God answers prayer, doesn't he? Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Anybody else got a praise report? Let's hear it. Anybody? Anybody? I tell you right now, he's good. I'm glad I got up this morning. I was breathing, wouldn't you?
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. God's a good God. We're going to do some praise and worship here this morning. And, you know, tonight I want you to be in much prayer. We got the service in the prison in Columbia, South Carolina. Some of us will be going. Y'all be praying that God's going to touch and meet some needs down there because those folks need it too. Amen. And there's a lot of folks on that internet this morning. We thank you for being with us this morning. We pray God's going to touch you spiritually. And if you need a physical touch in your body, we're going to pray that God's going to touch you there too. Amen. Let's just go to the Lord in prayer this morning in agreement that God will move on these situations. Amen. Father, we love you this morning and we praise you and we worship you, God. We come in this house to praise you and worship you this morning, God. Lord, we pray, God, that you'll just move in a mighty way. You'll touch the congregation here this morning. You'll touch the people on the internet this morning in a mighty way. You'll touch and bless and anoint the praise and worship this morning to glorify you. Lord, you'll anoint my sister Jeanette to deliver the message this morning. You'll anoint Nathan to deliver the message tonight. You'll anoint me to deliver the message in Columbia, South Carolina tonight, God, to move on them people down there, God, and touch and meet needs, God. Lord, we praying for the people on the internet. We pray, God, in Jesus' name, you'll touch if they have a physical need in their body. You're God that heals, and we claim it upon them this morning, God. And Lord, if they have a spiritual need and they do not know you as Lord and Savior, we pray this morning, God, that the Holy Ghost will convict them and touch their hearts, and they'll give their heart and soul to you this morning, God, the most important thing, God. And Lord, we pray right now, we pray for Buddy, God. We lift Buddy up to you, God. We pray in the name of Jesus, God, that you'll let blood drive, Lord, that you'll let it be successful, God, in Jesus' name. We pray for Kendra's son, Casey. We lift him up to you. Lord, we pray you touch his head and heal his body, God, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we pray for Donnie Deal, Lord, our brother. We lift him up to you, God. We pray that you'll heal his body supernaturally right now, God, where he's at. God, you'll take the pain away and you'll heal him, God, in Jesus' name. We ask it, God. We pray for the anointing in the prison service, God. We pray for Steve right now, God. We pray in the name of Jesus, God, that you touch his back and you heal it, God, by your stripes, 39 stripes. You took it upon your back, God, 39 stripes, God, for each and every one of our healing here this morning, God. We pray for Steve, God, that you'll take the pain away right now. You get that back in shape, those nerves, that inflammation, that sonic nerve, everything will be healed. I pray you touch Betty's back right now and heal her, God, in Jesus' name. I pray in the name of Jesus, God, that you'll move upon her, God, and heal her right where she's sitting this morning, God. I pray for Cheryl, Lord, you'll heal her body. Lord, I lift her up to you, God, in Jesus' name. I pray for the Vacation Bible School this weekend, God, that you'll touch children in a mighty way, God. Lord, we love you and we praise you this morning, God. We pray that you'll have your way this morning in the name of Jesus. And everybody said amen and amen. Praise God. Oh, I feel him up here already. Amen. Ha-ha! I've got a surprise for you this morning. Let me go over here and get my guitar. Praise the Lord. God's good, ain't he? Everybody seemed to be ready this morning. Amen. Now, the Lord gave me some songs this morning. Yeah, stand up. I want you to just really stand up and get ready. Love y'all. Praise God. Just love you this morning. Now, the Lord gave me some songs this morning, and they wanting to fly away up here. And before we start on the songs that God gave me, I want to do something else. I'm going to sing a song to start out here, and I want everybody to just go around and shake everybody's hand. I want you to move around a little bit, and I want you to just let the Holy Ghost come in here and touch. Amen. I'm trying to think of the song. It happens that way sometimes, Teresa, you know. You've been up here picking with us before, amen. Just go around and touch everybody's hand and just tell them how much you appreciate them and love them. Well, we might as well. On that resurrection morning, when the redeemed are gathered in, I'll join in that royal number when they call out my name, when they all join and sing hallelujah to the King. I'll cry with joyful sound, Lord, here I am. Here I am, here I am, here I am. I'm the one the shepherd led, the boy and bound. They were 99, but he left the fold to find one little old lamb, Lord, here I am. Now listen. No, Gabriel blows that trumpet, and we rise up in the air. In this time, a split second, we'll be chambered in there, where there'll be no grief or pain. Perfect peace and joy shall reign. All men let proclaim, Lord, here I am. Here I am. Here I am. I'm the one the shepherd left upon and bound. There were 99, but he left the fold to find one little old lamb, Lord, here I am. I like it. When old Gabriel blows that trumpet and we rise up in the air, in less time, a split second, we'll be changed from the dew there, where there'll be no grief or pain, for big peace and joy shall reign. Home and let's proclaim, Lord, here I am. Here I am. Here I am. No, Gabriel blows that trumpet, and we rise up in the air. In this time, a split second, we'll be chained from in there, where there'll be no grief or pain. Perfect peace and joy shall reign. Oh, man, let's proclaim, Lord, here I am. Here I am. Here I am. I'm the one the shepherd left a boy and found. There were 99, but he left the fold to find one little old lamb, Lord, here I am. There were 99, but he left the fold to find one little old lamb, Lord, here I am. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, don't that feel better? Amen. All right, you folks, get back in your seat. What are you out there mucking around for? Come on now. Praise the Lord. Don't that feel better? Amen. Ain't nothing like it. Praise God. I'm just messing with you now. Amen. Oh, that feels good. I like it myself. God's so good. I want you to listen to the words of this song and just think about it. Amen. Well, if Jesus says I'm saved,
then I'm saved.
If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe in what he said. If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe in what he said. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. If Jesus says I'm free, then I'm free. Jesus says I'm free, then I'm free. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe in what he said. If Jesus says I'm free, then I'm free. If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe what he said. If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe in what he said. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus says I'm free, then I'm free. If he said it, I believe it, don't you? Amen. Hallelujah. If it's in his word, it's him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I kind of like his song. Lord, you know I want to go to heaven, see the streets of gold and the crystal sea. And Lord, you know I want to go to heaven, see the mansion you built for me. There'll be no death, there'll be no sorrow, no pain. When we get up there, there'll be no tears, there'll be no crying. All the former things will pass away. Well now, Lord, you know I want to go to heaven, see the streets of gold and the crystal sea. And Lord, you know I want to go to heaven, see the mansion you built for me. I want to see Jesus in all his splendor. I want to see God and his glory too. I want to see my family that's gone before me, and all my loved ones that's a coming too. When I, Lord,
You know I want to go to heaven and see the streets of gold and the crystal sea. And Lord, you know I want to go to heaven and see the mansion you built for me. I want to see Jesus in all his splendor. I want to see God and his glory too. I want to see my family that's gone before me, and all my loved ones that's a coming too. When I look, you know I want to go to heaven, see the streets of gold and the crystal sea. And Lord, you know I want to go to heaven, see the mansion you built for me, and see the mansion you built for me.
Praise the Lord. How many wants to go? Amen. Hallelujah. I really want to go on that second load, but I'll go on the first one too. As I walk through the door, I sense his presence, and I knew it was a place where love abounds. For this is the temple Jehovah God abides here. Oh, we are standing in his presence on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground, and I know that there are angels all around. Let us pray. Presence, there is joy beyond measure, and at his feet peace of mind can still be found. If you have a need, I know he has the answer. Just reach out and claim it. We are standing on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground. And I know that they are angels all around. Let us pray. In his presence there is joy beyond measure, and at his feet peace of mind can still be found. If you have a need, I know he has the answer.
Just reach out and claim it. You are standing on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground. And I know that there are angels all around. Let us in his presence on holy ground. We are standing in his presence on holy ground. We are standing in his presence on holy ground.
Hallelujah, Lord. We praise you and we worship you, God. I claim the blood. Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains were made there just for me. Through all my sins, my sickness and my pain. When I need healing, I claim those precious blood stains. I do not know how others make it through. Who've never as I do, for there's a healing cleansing stream still flows, where peace and only his redeemed can ever know. I claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains were made there just for me. Through all my sin, my sickness and my pain, when I need healing, I claim those precious blood stains. I do not know how others make it through, who've never gone to Calvary as I do. For there's a healing cleansing stream still flows, with peace and only his redeemed will ever know. I claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains were made there just for me. Through all my sin, my sickness, my pain, when I need healing, I claim those precious blood stains. I claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains were made there just for me. Oh, my sin,
stand. When I need healing, I claim the precious blood stains.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood of Jesus.
You'll help me sing this. Sing it to Him. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. None go with me, I still will follow. Though none go with me, I still will follow. Though none go with me, I still will follow. Petekabashundai Imakai Dai Babashuka Maya Halakabashuta Mahadabashundai Ilote Baha Dakabashumaya Okatai Okatai Hadabashuta Mahalakabashundai Ilote Baha Mahatishi Ilote He Baha Latamashe He Dakabashundai Umahaya Okate Okate Heda Atakabashukate Itetai Ukamahadabashundai O Latate Hedakabashunda Atakabashukate Elalabashunda Ma Akate Uhata Itaha Lutabashutana Maya Uhakate Maya Lakabashundai O Mashute He Mashute Olalabai Ibabashushata O Tete Mande Hilakabashundai Imahadabashua Akate Lalabashukata A Mande Hilakabashunda He Baba Ukataba Hilakabashutai. Follow me, saith the Lord. Follow me, saith the Lord. Come with me, saith the Lord. Put all of your trust in me. Go with me. Follow me, saith the Lord. Come with me. I have special things for you. I have needs that you are yearning for. I see your needs. I will give you those needs that your heart is crying out for. But you must follow me, you must seek me, you must come after me with your whole heart, saith the Lord. You must seek me diligently, saith the Lord. I have so many things for you that you can't even imagine. I have already paid the price for you. You have been bought and paid for by a great price. My son, saith the Lord, paid the price for you with his precious blood. He shed on Calvary for you. That you might have these things that I have for you. You have needs. I know you do. I see them. But I am a God that cares for you. I am a God that seeks your face. I want you to seek my face because I love you. I want you to come after me, saith the Lord. And I'll show you things that you can't even imagine. Your heart can't even imagine what I have for you. Because my love is so great for you. My yearning for you and fellowship with you is overwhelming, saith the Lord. When you give me praises, it gives me glory, says God. Because I love you. I love you. I have many things for you, saith the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Seek my face, and I will be found. Seek my face, and I will hear your voice. Seek my face, saith the Lord, and I will answer your prayers because I love you, my children. I love you, saith the Lord. Come after me. Come after me wholeheartedly, saith God. Do not let the cares of the world steal from you. Come after me, saith the Lord, and live that victorious life that I have for you, saith God. It's yours. It's been bought and paid for by a great price, saith the Lord thy God.
Shimaya Yamokoya Hasia Yuya Uya Yamuai Yakoya Yamokoya Hasaya Ya Ikaya Ayaya Uya Ikuyahai, uyamosiyai, uyakaya, uyakaya, uyamahi, ayaya, oi, uyamokai, uyamokai.
Y'all sing it with me, you know it.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder considered all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displays. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! My Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Hallelujah, Hosea. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want everybody to stand. Can't get this one out. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
Yeah.
How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How
how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Could you give me some ushers, please? God bless you this morning. Brother D. Wayne. Well, if Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe in what he said. If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe in what he said. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. Jesus says I'm free, then I'm free. If Jesus says I'm free, then I'm free. If Jesus' word said it, then I believe in what he says. If Jesus says I'm free, then I'm free. If Jesus says I'm healed, then I'm healed. If Jesus says I'm saved, then I'm saved. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm going to ask my sister Jeanette. Pastor Jeanette, come. Oh, yeah, that's right. Who got the special? I'm sorry. Donna, come on up here, girl. Vacation Bible School. We appreciate Donna. She's done a great job with those kids, I'll tell you right now. I forgot you, girl.
Must be. You know, we all go through different troubles and trials, and
Am I on? Amen. Sorry about that. I just don't like if you just see me pull my blouse, you know, work with it, trying to get the microphone on. It's a pleasure to be able to stand before you today and give this message. This was a message that the Lord started showing me about actually just a little time right after Roy passed and went to be with the Lord. And I just put it on the shelf, so to speak. And so the Lord told me 2 weeks ago, get it off the shelf. So today we're going to start with it. And the title of this message today I would give would be called Authority. We're going to start with Proverbs. While you're finding Proverbs 4:13, instructions is the first part of this message. And before authority comes instructions. Proverbs 4:13 says, take fast hold of instruction. Let her not go, keep her, for she is thy life. Instruction here means disciple or discipline. Jesus gave instructions to the disciples. Instructions was given in Matthew 28:10 to the women after the resurrection. He said, be not afraid. Go tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and there shall they see me. Now, Jesus calls his disciples for the first time here brethren. Up to this time, he had called them, actually before his passion in John 15, 14, and 15, which I don't want you to pull that up, but he gives them another title. He is not ashamed to call them brethren. But before his passion, he called them friend. He said, don't call yourself any longer. I don't call you any longer a servant. I call you a friend. And then he gives them this new name, brethren. Brethren means co-worker or brotherhood. It's really a name of endearment, but it's actually letting them know that he's going to be along beside them in what they do in ministry, and he's going to send them forth. So he calls them co-workers. And then in Hebrews 2:11, it says, for he that sanctifieth and who was sanctified, set apart for service, are all of one, for which cause he is not ashamed or embarrassed to call them brethren. And then also in a couple more places in Mark 14:28 and Matthew 26:32, which say pretty much the same thing, instructions were given by Jesus here when he said, but after I'm risen, I will go before you into Galilee. And then instructions were given by an angel in Matthew 28:7. Where it says, and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead, and behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall you see him. Lo, I have told you. And then Matthew 28:16, it says, then the 11 disciples went away into Galilee, into the mountain where Jesus had appointed them. So after instructions were given, obedience came. Authority is given following instructions and obedience. And then worship. Authority is given following instructions and obedience and worship. So say with me, authority is given following instructions, obedience, and worship. Matthew 28:17 says, and when they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. Many that were there and worshiped him at his ascension, that were there, those there that doubted. That doubted him, what he had done, and they kind of turned their backs and walked away, I believe. I could just kind of see that as they're standing before him at his ascension. Obedience takes faith, but unbelief never received anything from the Lord. So the ones that stayed there, they stayed in faith, believing, and out of obedience, and out of following the instructions that the Lord gave him, and it says they worshiped him. Matthew 28:18 says, "And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth." So the one that gave Jesus his authority and gave him his power, it came from the Father. Authority is given to Jesus by the Father. Matthew 11:27. I'm going to read out the King James and the Amplified. King James says, "All things are delivered unto me by my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father. Neither knoweth any man the Father, save or except the Son, and whosoever the Son will reveal him," which is us. Amplified. "All things have been entrusted and delivered to me by my Father, and no one fully knows and accurately understands the Son except the Father, and no one knows and accurately understands the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son deliberately wills to make him known," which I like that translation even better. Matthew 28:18, Jesus said, "All power is given unto me in heaven and earth." And all power in the Greek here means delegated authority. So the authority that Jesus got from the Father was called delegated authority. That's what we call it anyway, is delegated authority. Liberty, and this means liberty to exercise the full power of attorney in all God's interest. I'm going to say that again. This is liberty to exercise the full power of attorney in all God's interest. And also complete authority to act in God's stead as if God himself were doing the work. I'm going to repeat that one. Complete authority to act in God's stead as if God himself were doing the work. And power to act as freely as his own will, of his own will, as one has power to eat and drink. Authority means the lawful right to enforce obedience. Jesus Christ's power was unlimited in doing the will and work of God on earth, and now he has the all power in heaven and in earth. Delegated authority to believers. This is where I'm trying to get to, but I had to lay a background for it. Mark 16:17 reads, "In my name, in the name of Jesus, he authorized us." Have you got Matthew? Yeah. "And these signs shall follow them that believe in my name." And I want to stop there for right now. In his name, the authority in his name, the delegated authority that we have to use his name. He gave us his name as the authority and the authority to use his name. We can speak for him. Because if we know what the will of the Father is, and we have to find that in the Word of God, then we know what his will is. It's his will to heal. It's his will to deliver. It's his will to save. It's his will to heal relationships and families. Anything that you pray, and you pray in the name of Jesus, you are actually using your authority in that name of Jesus. He gave us the name recognized in three worlds, the name that has authority in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. Angels, men, and demons have to bow at the name of Jesus. And when Jesus comes back and to his reign on this earth, every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Christ now promises to share his earthly power with believers. We call this, as I said a minute ago, delegated authority. Matthew 28:19-20. These things that I'm reading in Matthew 28 is things that Jesus said to the disciples as he was getting ready to ascend. And what he said here in Matthew 28:19-20 says, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world." Amen. And then in Acts 10:42, he commanded us to preach unto people and testify that it is he which was ordained of God to be the judge of the quick, the living, and the dead. He commanded them. He said, go ye into all the world. And he says, I have commanded you, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. So he has given us commands in his word, the things that he said to these disciples, and he is saying to us as he was getting ready to be ascended into heaven. It was interesting to me to think about the things that he said right there before he went to be at the right hand of the Father. I enjoyed just knowing the words that he said. You know, my husband used to tell me, he said, Jeanette, I love the word of God so much. He said, I could just eat the red print. And he meant it. He memorized much of the scriptures. Verse 43 of Acts 10 says, To him give all the prophets witness that through his name, whosoever believeth in him shall receive remission or forgiveness of sins. So when we get saved, it's through the name of Jesus. We come to Jesus and we ask him to forgive us for our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And that we take him into our hearts, and we all know this. Everybody in here that I know right now is a Christian. And you know that you had to come one way, and that was through Jesus. You can only get to the Father through that name, through the name of Jesus. I wanted to read to you Acts 1:1-11. And I've got this in my Bible, so I didn't have time to type it in. I was thinking about this morning. Because these are not the things here, and then I'm going to get to the other. It's not the only things that Jesus said before he ascended. And so Acts chapter 1, I'm going to start with verse 1 and read through 11. The former treatise, or the former book, I have made or written, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach, until the day in which he was taken up, after he through the Holy Ghost had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs. And we know there's one time that 500 people saw him. That's 40 days that he was on the earth after he arose from the grave. He was 40 days, and he was with his disciples. He would appear and disappear. And he would say whatever he said was very important. But this was right before he ascended that he gave this commandment. He says, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which he saith, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel, or give back the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons for which the Father hath put in his own power. In verse 8, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and to the uttermost parts of the earth. Mark 16:15-18. I know I've got a lot of scriptures, but I just want to prove to you what I'm saying, you know, and I like the scriptures. They're more important than anything I can say, except what the Holy Ghost wants to say. And he said unto them, go you into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be condemned or damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. This doesn't mean that you can just go out in your backyard. And there was a black snake not far from my house one day this week over at Miss Porter's on a bush, and I saw it. And it was all curled, you know. And I thought, you know, that's a black snake. It's not going to hurt me. It's, you know, it'll take care of rodents and other snakes. But I did not go over and pick that snake up. And if it was a deadly snake, I definitely would not go over and pick it up. I think that's tempting God. I know that some people like Richard will pick them up, and he knows how to do it. But not me. Not me, Richard. And you can come get that one out of the attic. I think there's one about 8 feet long and as big round as a man's arm. And if you would come over there in Miss Porter's attic and get that out, that would be great. The guy's putting the heating and air conditioning in saw it. He said it kind of lifted up a suitcase and come crawling out from under there. That would have been the last with me in that attic. But if you'll come get it, I won't be afraid to go back up there unless there's some babies up there or something. I don't know. Look at verses 19 and 20. So then after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God, this showing his deity, and that he, which means that he is God. And he went forth and they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word with signs following. The Lord working with them. We are his brethren, his co-workers. He expects us to get off of our seats and get busy for him in his kingdom. He expects us to do what he's called us to do. He expects us to overcome every obstacle that's in our way, that Satan puts in our way to try to cause us trouble or confusion or hurt. He wants us to get off of our seats and get busy. Roy would say something else, but I decided not to. The Lord working with them, and the authority he gives us is to use the name of Jesus. That's very simple. That's the authority we have, is to use Jesus' name. And I have claimed the blood of Jesus over things too, but I'm still using his name when I do it. There is salvation in that name. There is healing in that name. There is deliverance in that name. And there is power in that name of Jesus. We are to use the authority we have in Jesus' name against the tricks of the enemy of our souls. And we can bind him and stand. And when we've done all to stand, we stand. I've bound the devil many times and then kind of wondered if, is it going to really happen, you know, is it? But you remember the story Roy told about cows in the pasture and how they were bothering us while we were trying to put up a fence or actually trying to cut down trees. And every time, there were about 13 of them, and they were real friendly cows. And about the time that we would get to with a chainsaw and get to a tree to start cutting it up, here they'd come with their noses right in what we were doing. And so Roy said, what are we going to do, Jeanette? We, you know, could hurt these cows or, you know, they could cause us to get hurt or whatever. They're getting in our way. And I said, well, let's just bind them. So we bound the cows. And it wasn't but just a few minutes that we saw cows running down through the field toward the river. And it was kicking up its feet and yelling and, you know, whatever they do, bellowing. And took off down there to the river. And Saluda River, because it's right behind our house. And so we didn't think no more about it. We just kept on working. So about 3 days later, we heard from Roy's Uncle Denzel. And he said, he's telling Roy's mom, he said, Hazel, I can't find my cows. He said, they were okay 3 days ago, but today I can't find them. And so he took off down, and he went down to the river, and he found them. There's a little swampy area, and some of you have been down there, and you know where that little area is. And they wouldn't come out, no matter what he did, because at one point he could be on the other side of the river, over there near River Road, and they could hear his voice, and they would swim across the river to Denzel. So his mama said, I don't know, you know, I'll ask Roy, you know. And so he came over there, and Roy and I looked at each other, and we said, we got to loose those cows. And so we loosed them. And the next day he went down there with a bucket of food, and they just followed him right on out of the swamp. There are things that if it's necessary to bind, that we can do that. And we have that authority because Jesus has delegated that authority to us to use his name. I don't know your experiences, but I know mine, a white German shepherd came against my daughter and me as we were coming out of beauty shop one day. And it was standing there and it was showing its teeth and it was growling and barking at us. And we knew we were in danger. You just kind of know it, that they mean business when they mean business. It looked like nobody's pet. And so, anyway, I told Rhonda, I just said, and Rhonda and I were both there, and we were we couldn't get back to the door, to the shop, because he was right there at the car door, right in front of us. And the car door was open, and I said, in the name of Jesus, I command you to turn around and go the other way. And why I said it that way, I don't know. It just came out of my mouth. It was because I knew that I had that authority and because God gives it to us. And when we practice it, it comes natural to use his name. And that dog stopped in his tracks. He turned around and he left. And I don't know which way he went, but he went another way. So we've got that authority to use to come against the enemy that comes against us, not just in our bodies, but comes against us in certain situations. There's times when I will say I bind every power, every principality, the rulers of the darkness of this world, and the spiritual wickedness in high places in the name of Jesus over somebody when I'm praying for them. And the reason I do it, I want to cover all of the wickedness and spiritual evil wickedness and the powers that's working in that situation. I know Jesus said for us to be sure of this one thing, I am with you always, even to the end of the world. You know, I know, and I've said this many times to the Lord before I've ever gotten up and or done anything really, I say, we can't do anything without him. I tell him, I say, Lord, I can do nothing without you, and without you I am nothing. But he still expects us to go forth and bear fruit. We can't do it, but he can do it through us. Have you ever come up against something that you knew you couldn't do? Well, it's usually God. It's usually God, and he's going to show you that, no, you can't do it, but I can do it through you. Like me standing up here preaching, it has to be God because it's not me. I can't make up a sermon. I can't make up anything. I can study the Bible and I can quote some scriptures, but I can't give a message without the Lord is working in me. So he says, I'm with you always, even to the end of the world, through everything that you go through. Through things in your life that you need to take authority over and use Jesus' name and believe it when you say it, when you pray it. That's all I got. Because I've told the Lord, I'll give what you give me and nothing more. And I'll try to do nothing less. Let's bow our heads. Father, in the name of Jesus, I know there's many out here and maybe on the internet that are going through things in their lives and they feel like they've come up against a brick wall. And they have forgotten that you have given us as Christians authority to use the name of Jesus to come against the wicked things that's going on around us. That we know that the enemy, Satan, is the one that's an author of. And so, Father, in the name of Jesus, over the lives of everyone that's on the internet that's watching and over the congregation today at this church, these people I love so dear, I bind every power, every principality, the rulers of the darkness of this world and the spiritual wickedness in high places that is coming against them through any way, through their children, through their homes, this young man that Russell asked me to pray for, and through anything that's going on in their lives, whether it's spiritual, physical, or financial, Lord. I bind the enemy. You will take your hands off of these people. I am their pastor, and I have the authority to speak this over them and speak healing and deliverance and salvation to their families and peace to their minds and deliverance to them. Anything they need, I speak it over this congregation today. And Lord, I thank you that you've given us the authority, that you have delegated it to us, Father, like you delegated it to Jesus, and then he has delegated it to us. And I thank you that the Holy Spirit is working in our lives. I thank you, Father, that without Jesus going and ascending to the Father, which was probably hard on some of those followers that were there, he did call them his brethren, his co-workers. And then he ascended and is sitting at the right hand of the Father, you, Lord, now. And now I ask the Holy Spirit to come and minister to everybody. We've taken authority, but we also have the Holy Spirit living inside of us, dwelling inside of us, this body, this temple of the Holy Spirit. I thank you for that, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Go enjoy your chicken or whatever you're going to have. And I know I always let you out early, but I'm just not long-winded, I guess. Enough, maybe, sometimes.